Hello everyone, my name is Khanam and today in this project we will see PHP CRUD operation. CRUD, C stands for create, R stands for read, U stands for update and D stands for delete. This data what is displayed I got from database. Okay, I have this add user button, I have this update button and I have this delete button. If I click on add users, I'll be getting this page where I can add users. Like suppose if I add my name Khanam and email I'll give it as khanam@gmail.com and mobile number I'll give 1 and password I'll give 123. If I click on submit and see here the data what I gave here, it's coming here. Okay, it's dynamically getting displayed from my database and I have this delete button and I have this update button. Now ID 6, if I toggle to this, you can see here down I'm getting that ID number. You can see here I'm getting delete ID is equal to 7, here it is 8, here it is 9. Okay, so if I click on this, you can see my ID 6 will get deleted. Okay, if I want to update this one, you can just click on update and my ID is 7 now. If I click on update, see all the data related to 7 ID will be displayed on my fields. I can just update whatever fields I want. I'll just update the mobile number. I'll click on update. You can see the mobile number has been updated. Okay, if I click on ID number 8, see all the data whatever is related to ID number 8 will be displayed on my fields so that I can update it. Instead of Seema, if I give here Rita and email also I want to change. I want to give Rita, mobile I'll change. I'll give 000, password I'll give 234. Now if I click on save, you can see the data has been updated. Okay, if I click on add users, you can add new user and if you click on submit, the data will be submitted. If you click on update, I have this update button and all the data related to that field, it will be displayed here and you can update that particular field. And we have this delete operation. If I click on delete, the ID 7 will get deleted. Okay, let's see how to create this one. Let's just create a database. I'll just click on this new tab and I'll be typing here localhost php myadmin. You can see here localhost php myadmin. Okay, enter this one. Okay, we got our php myadmin dashboard and here you will be having all the databases what you have created. Okay, I'll just click on new. I want new database. I'll click on new. I'll give my database name as CRUD operation. Okay, I'll click on create. See, my database has been created. You can see here CRUD operation has come here. Now if click on this create table, I'll give my table name as CRUD and I want total 1 serial number, name, email, mobile and password. Operations we are not going to save inside the database, only serial number, name, email, mobile and password. So I want 5 fields. I'll just click on go. Now first I'll give my ID, second is my name, third is my email, fourth is my mobile and fifth is my password. Now data type I'll give it as int for my ID, for name I'll give varchar, email I'll give varchar, mobile I'll give varchar, password I'll be giving varchar. If I don't give the length for my ID, it will take default as 11. For my name I'll give 100, for email I'll give 100, for mobile I'll just give 20 and for password I'll give 255. For my ID I'll just give this auto increment value and the primary key, okay, so that it increments automatically and each time I don't have to enter the ID while entering the username and everything. Okay, so I'll just click on this auto increment. AI stands for auto increment and I'll just give here primary key. Okay, you have here many options, just click on primary key. Once we are done with creating our table, just click on save. See, now our table is being created. You can see ID, we have this primary key, name field, email, mobile and password. Inside our CRUD operation database, we have our CRUD table. Inside the table, we have these 5 fields, ID, name, email, mobile and password. Okay, now let's come to our VS Code editor. Okay. I have already opened my XAMPP and I have started my Apache and MySQL. Okay, MySQL is a database and Apache will be acting as a local server for PHP. Okay, just minimize this one. Open XAMPP folder wherever you have installed. Go to htdocs and here I have created my CRUD folder. I'll just open this one. Right click on this folder and open with code. Okay, I have already opened my VS Code editor. Here inside this one, First, I'll be creating one file. I'll give my file name as user.php. First, let's just create this one. When I click on add user, first I want to create this one, and when I click on submit, only then my data should be displayed. Okay, so I'll be using Bootstrap for this. I'll just come here. I'll be giving this get Bootstrap. Now inside my Bootstrap website, I have the starter template. I'll just copy this one, and inside my user.php, I'll paste my Bootstrap template here. I'll just remove this JavaScript. I don't need this one for this project. I'll just remove this, and from the CSS, I'll just remove this part and I'll click on save. I'll copy the path. I'll just come to new tab. I'll paste the path, and instead of this, I'll just give localhost. Now, if I click on enter, you can see my output has come. Okay, now we are ready to build our output. I'll just change my title. I'll give my title as CRUD operation. I'll just remove this one. I'll wrap, I'll take one div, and I'll give my class name as container. Okay, container is Bootstrap class. Two types of classes in Bootstrap, container and container fluid. I have taken container. Container will divide the width equally between left and right, and container fluid will take the entire width. For this, I'm taking container. I'll just come to Bootstrap. I want form. I'll just click on form. Here I have this form. See, I'll just copy this simple form. I'll copy the entire code of this. You can see this will be the output for that. I'll just come here and I'll be pasting it here. Now once I refresh this one, you can see my form has come. Now in my project, I have name, email, mobile and password. Okay, let's just do that one. Let's modify our code. Now inside this form, first I'll be giving method is equal to post. Action I'm not giving because I want to perform the action in the same page, in the same user.php. So only I'm giving this method is equal to post. Okay, now I'll just clean my code. I'll just remove this for. I'll be removing this everything. Placeholder, I'll give enter your name. Here I'll give name. I'll remove this entire thing. I'll remove this small as well. Enter your name, and name field I'll give it as name. Now I'll save this. Type I'll give it as text. Type also we have to change. Type I'll give it as text. Now I'll save this one. This is my class. I'll just close my div here. I'll save this one. Now if I come and if I refresh this one, you can see only my name field has come and I have this button. Okay, now I'll just copy this. I'll just format the document. Now I'll just copy this entire div and I'll be pasting it here. I'll just change name to email. I'll give the type as email. Placeholder, I'll give enter your email. And name, I'll give it as email. Okay, now again, I'll copy this and I'll be pasting it here. Next is my mobile number. I'll just change it to mobile. Here also, I'll be giving mobile. Enter your mobile. Enter your mobile number. Here, I'll give mobile. Okay, type, I want text. Now if I come and if I refresh this, you can see my name, email, mobile, and one more is our password field. Okay, let's create our password field. I'll just copy this div and I'll be pasting it here. For my password, I'll just change this label. I'll give password, enter your password, and here also I want to change to password. Okay, type, let it be text. I'll save this one now. Now if I refresh this, you can see my password field has come. Now in our project, we have space above. So let's just give that margin. So inside my container, I'll just give margin 5 is equal to 5. Okay, this class will add top and bottom margin of 5. I'll just enter. You can see I got margin. So that I don't get suggestion of my ID and name. Autocomplete is equal to off. I'll just off this one. And if I come and if I refresh this, now we are ready with our form. Okay, I'm not getting any suggestion of my email, name, mobile and password. Okay, now whenever I enter the data, when I click on submit, all my data should be stored inside my database. Okay, so for that, first we have to connect to our database. I'll create one file. I'll give my file name as connect.php. Now inside this one, I'll just write this PHP syntax. Now inside connect.php, I'll create one connection variable and I'll be connecting to my database. I'll be writing this one, mysqli. In this, first I'll be passing my localhost, that is my server name, localhost. My username is root, my password. If you have not changed your password, then it will be empty. I have changed my password, so I am giving my password. And here I'll be passing my database name. My database, what I created was CRUD operation. Okay, I'll just pass my database name here, CRUD operation. Now I'll check my condition. If my connection is successful, then just show me connection successful. Else, just show me an error where I went wrong, mysqli error. And this will be taking, I'll just remove this. And here I'll be passing my connection variable. I'll save this one. I'll just copy the path of this file and I'll come to new tab. I'll paste the path and instead of this one, I'll just give localhost. I'll click on save. You can see connection successful, which means that I am successfully connected to my database, this database. Now I just don't want to show this one, connection successful. Now once I got to know my connection is successful, I will just remove this one and condition I'll change it to not. If it is not connected, then show me this error, or else it means that we are connected to our database. Now I'll click on save. I'll save this one. Now if I refresh this, you can see I did not get any error, which means that I am successfully connected to my database. Now I'll close this, and also I'll close this one. Now I don't need that file. Now let's insert our data inside the database. We are done with creating database and we'll be reading the data from the database. Okay, so for that, inside my user.php, I'll just come here above. Okay, I'll be writing my PHP syntax. I'll close my PHP syntax here. First, I want to connect to my database. So I'll be giving this include. Inside single quotes, I'll give this connect.php. Okay, now here for my button, you can see here my button. For my button, I'll give this name attribute and I'll give the name attribute as submit. Now I'll save this. Here I'll check one condition, if is set dollar post. Okay, because I have passed post method here inside my form. You can see here post. Okay, that method, if it is set to submit, then only I want to enter the data and then only I want to store the data inside my database. Okay, first I have name, second I have email, third I have mobile, fourth I have password. Now here I'll just give this post and I'll be assigning the values whatever I have passed inside my name attribute. Okay, for name I have passed name, for email I have this email, for password and mobile I have mobile and password. Okay, I'll just come here. For name, I'll just give here name. For email, I'll be passing email. Mobile, I'll give it as mobile. And password, I'll give password. This inside the name attribute, whatever you have passed, it should be matching with this one. Okay, you should write the exact same thing here. Now I'll be writing my insert query. For that, I'll create one variable SQL. Okay, inside that, I'll create my insert query, insert into table name. My table name is CRUD. The table what I created, my table name is CRUD here, you can see. Okay, insert into table name. Inside my table, I'll just give this column names. Name I have, email I have, mobile and password. कि दीज आर माई कॉलम नेम्स एंड इन साइड दैट वैल्यूज आई वॉन्ट टू पास वॉट एवर आई हैव असाइंड हियर. ओके दिस वैल्यू आई हैव असाइंड टू दिस वेरिएबल, दिस वैल्यू आई हैव असाइंड टू दिस वेरिएबल. ओके दैट वेरिएबल्स आई विल बी पासिंग इट हियर एज वैल्यू सो दैट ईच टाइम आई विल बी गेटिंग डिफरेंट वैल्यूज. आई विल बी पासिंग माई फर्स्ट माई नेम वेरिएबल, सेकेंड इज माई ईमेल वेरिएबल. ओके दीज आर वैल्यूज एंड दीज आर वारकार डेटा टाइप सो यू शुड एनक्लोज इट विन सिंगल कोट्स. And I'll just give here mobile. And my next value is my password. I'll just give that one. Now to execute this query, I'll create one variable. I'll give my variable name as result. Inside this one, I'll be passing this MySQLi query method. Okay, and this method will be taking two parameters. First is our connection variable, and second is our query variable. Okay, this method will allow us to execute this query. Now I'll check the condition. If my query has executed successfully, okay, I'll just pass my result here. Okay, if it is true, then show me data inserted successfully. Okay, else I'll just come to my connect.php and I'll copy this MySQLi error and I'll be pasting it here. Else show me error where I went wrong. Okay, this is the code. We are inserting data inside a database. Now let's just come to our project. I'll refresh this one. Now I'll enter name. I'll enter name as Khanum. I'll enter my email khanum@gmail.com. I'll give mobile number. I'll give password 123. I'll click on submit. See, you can see data inserted successfully, which means that my data inside my database has been successfully inserted. Now I'll refresh this one. Okay, now I'll come to my browse. I'll just come to browse. Now you can see here my data has been inserted. Whatever I inserted inside my table, okay, inside this field, that has been inserted. I'll refresh again. I'll give one more name, Ria. I'll give email as ria@gmail.com. Mobile I'll give 4567890. Password I'll give 234. I'll click on submit. You can see data inserted successfully. I'll come to my database. I'll refresh my database. Now you can see the data what I entered there, it has been inserted inside my database. Okay, this is how we'll be inserting data inside the database. Now let's see this data, whatever is inside my database, it should dynamically get displayed on my website. Okay, so for that what I'll be doing is I'll just remove the spaces from here. I'll be creating one new file. I'll give my file name as display.php. Now inside this file I'll just write this basic snippet of HTML. I'll change my title CRUD operation. Now I'll just come to user.php and here I'll copy the CSS link and I'll be pasting my CSS link here. Okay, now you can see inside my user I have this one. I'll just come back. Now you can see this is the table I want to display. I have this button here. I'll just create that button. So for that first I'll create one div. I'll create one container. Inside that container I'll be creating one button. For my button, I'll just give my button text as add user. Now if I click on save and if I open that file, I'll paste the path here and instead of user, I'll just give display.php. You can see my button has come here. Let's style our button. For my button, I'll be giving class as btn primary. Okay, these are bootstrap classes. I'll just come and I'll refresh this one. You can see my button style have been applied. In our project we have space from above and below. I'll just give the margin 5. Now I'll refresh this. You can see I got margin of 5. Now I just want to wrap my button inside my anchor tag. So for that I'll be creating my anchor tag. Inside href I'll give my user.php file. And inside this anchor tag, I'll just write this text here. Okay, now I'll save this. Now I'll refresh this one. Now you can see my text color is not visible. So I'll just come to my display.php, and inside my anchor tag I'll create one class. I'll give my class name as text light. Now I'll come here and I'll refresh this one. You can see now my text is visible. Now if I click on this, you can see I am redirected to user.php. okay, now let's create our table here. So for that, below this anchor tag, I'll just come to Bootstrap and I'll search here table. I'll copy this basic code of this table. Okay, this is the basic table code. We have many options of table. You can select whichever table you want. Okay, I'll just copy this code and I'll be pasting my code here, the table code. Now I'll save this. I'll just come to my display.php file. I'll refresh this. You can see my table I have stored inside my button. I'll remove this. I'll store below my button. Now I'll refresh this. You can see my table has come. Now I'll change my heading, table headings. I have serial number, name, email, mobile, password and operation. Okay, let's change our headings here. First I'll remove this serial. I'll give serial number. Next I have name. Here I have email. I have mobile. And next I have password. And next I have operation. Now I'll save this. Now if I come and if I refresh this, you can see serial number, name, email, mobile, password and operation field have come here. Now this data I should get from this. Okay, whatever is displayed here, it should be displayed here directly. It should get displayed inside my website. Okay, for that we'll be writing code. Now here we'll be writing the code for displaying the data from the database. Okay, now you can see I have a table head. Table row is ending here and my table head has closed here. Okay, now inside the table body I have this tr tag. Okay, this is the data I have to display in my website. So here I'll be writing my PHP code. Okay, I'll be writing PHP code here. And inside this, I'll be displaying this one. So as of now, I'll just comment everything. This entire TR. Okay, whatever I have. I'll just save this one. And if I come here and if I refresh this, you can see all the data has gone now. Now I'll be writing PHP code for this. So I want to select all the data. So for that, I'll be writing one SQL query. And I'll give this select star, means I want all the data which whatever is stored inside the table, I want everything. Select star from my table name is CRUD. Okay, now to execute this query, I'll be creating one variable and I'll give my variable name as result, and I'll pass this MySQLi method, MySQLi query method, and this method will take two parameters. First is our connection variable and next is our query variable. Okay, now I'll be checking the condition. If my result is true, okay, if it is true, then I want to print all the data. If I show you, I'll show you one method. I'll just give this row. Okay, inside this, I'll just give this MySQLi fetch asoc. I'll just pass this method, and inside this, I'll pass this result. Okay, whatever this variable I have assigned, the value whatever I have assigned here, this variable I'll be passing inside my MySQLi fetch asoc function. Okay, now if I give this echo and I want to echo the name, okay, inside this I want to echo the name. I'll just give here dollar symbol. Now if I save this and if I come here and if I refresh this, I'm getting undefined variable con. Okay, I'll just connect my database here above. I'll just write this PHP and I just want to include my connect.php file. Now I'll save this. Now if I refresh this one, you can see the Khanum name has come. Okay, inside my database, my first name is Khanum. Okay, that has been printed here. Now if I want second name, I'll be writing the same query again. Okay, I'll just write this again and I'll be pasting it here. And also I want to print, I'll just come, I'll print this one. Now I'll come to my project. Now if I refresh this, you can see the name Riya has come. Whatever the name I have stored inside my table, okay, you can see here Khanam and Riya, it has been displayed here, Khanam and Riya. Okay, now suppose if I have here hundreds of records, I can't write each time, I can't be writing this, the same syntax I can't be writing. So I'll wrap this code inside my while loop. I'll create while loop, and inside this while loop, whatever I have written here, okay, I'll just paste it here, and I'll just remove this semicolon, and also I'll remove this entire thing. Okay, whatever I have written here, I just wrote to explain you. Now here I'll just open this braces, and inside this, inside my while loop, I want my ID. Okay, for that I'll be creating one ID variable, and inside this I want to extract my ID. Okay, so for that, this is my table field name ID. Next, I want to extract name field, so I'll be writing this row and I'll be passing this name. Next is my email. I'll be creating one variable for email, and I want to display my email, so I'll be writing this email. Next is my mobile. I'll be writing this, and row inside this I'll be passing my mobile column name. Next, I have password. Now row inside this, I'll just write my field password name. Now I'll just save this one. Now if I show you the output, you can't see anything because I have not given any echo statement. Now below this, I'll just give echo statement, open single quotes, and I'll close the semicolon here. Now inside my echo statement, I want to print the data inside my table. Okay, so this table row I'll copy from here, and I'll be pasting it here. Okay, now first inside my ID, I don't want this one, I want to give this variable. I'm just concatenating this one. If you can see here, this is the single quote, opening quote, and this is the closing quote. Okay, I have attached using dot symbol, and again this is the opening quote and this is the closing quote. Okay, this is the concatenation I have done. Next is my email, so I'll just give here email. I'll just concatenate with that one, it's name, sorry. I'll just give my name field, I'll concatenate this. Next, I want to print my email, I'll give this email field. Next, I have my mobile, I'll concatenate my mobile variable. And one more field I have, I'll just copy this, and next I have password. Now if I save this and if I show you the output, now you can see all the data, whatever is inside my database, you can see the name, Khanam, email, mobile and password. Okay, whatever is stored inside my database, that will get printed here. Now if I click on add user, and if I add one new user here, I'll give the name as Sita, and email I'll give sita@gmail.com, mobile I'll give 12345678, password 1234. Now if I submit, okay, data inserted successfully. Now you can see the data what I entered, it got displayed here. Okay, now whenever I enter the data, when I click on submit, I don't want this data inserted. Okay, I don't want this message to be shown, I should redirect it to my display.php file. So I'll just come to my user.php file, and here I have this data inserted. Okay, instead of this, I'll just give this header. Inside that, I'll be passing my location, and my location is display.php file. Now I'll save this, and now if I refresh here, and if I give some other name, I'll give Priya, email I'll give priya@gmail.com, mobile number I'll give some numbers, and password I'll give 234. I'll click on submit. You can see I am redirected to my display.php, and my data is being displayed here. Okay, and also in my database, my data will be stored here. If I refresh my database, you can see all the data whatever I have entered, like Khanam, Riya, Sita and Priya, everything will be inserted inside my database, as well as it will be displayed in my website. Okay, let us insert one more user. I'll just give Suresh. I'll give the username as suresh@gmail.com, mobile I'll give 12345678, and password I'll give 2345. Click on submit. You can see password I got 2345. Whatever data I inserted, it got displayed. Okay, now in our project, I have this update and delete button here. So let's just create our buttons here. I'll just come to my display.php file. This whatever I have commented, I'll just remove this one. Now I don't need this. As I'm getting the data directly from my database, I just remove that one. Now here below this, I want my buttons here. Now below this, I'll be creating my buttons. So I'll just write the buttons below my PHP tag so that I'll get this HTML colors, and later on I'll copy and I'll paste it here. I'll just write one TD tag inside this. I want button. I want two buttons. So I'll be writing this into two, and I want anchor tag for this. Okay. You can just see this one. If I enter, I got two buttons and anchor tag inside each button. Now first I'll just give here update button, and this will be my delete button. Now if I save, and now if I, okay, I just have to paste inside my, I'll copy this and I'll be pasting it here. Now you can see I have two buttons inside my TD tag, that is table data. I'll just refresh this. You can see my buttons have come here. Let's just give the Bootstrap class for button. I'll give this class btn primary will give blue color. Now if I refresh this, you can see I did not get class. I just have to close this one. Now I'll save this. Now you can see that color has been changed. And for this button, I'll just give class, and I'll give this class as btn danger. Now I'll save this. Now if I refresh, you can see my color has come. I'll just change the text color. To change the text color, I'll be giving the class inside my anchor tag. Okay, now here I'll be giving class. I'll give my text color as text light. I'll just copy the same class and I'll be pasting it inside this anchor tag. Now I'll save this. Now if I refresh, you can see my text color has been changed. Now if I click on update, I should get one update file, and if I click on delete, I should get one delete file. And whenever I click on delete, my data should get deleted, and whenever I click on update, this field should get updated. Okay, whatever I update, that should get updated. Now first let us create our delete operation. Okay, now if you see in my project, okay, in my previous project, if I toggle on delete down, you can see this delete ID is equal to 8. Okay, the ID number, this whatever I have here, it matches to that ID number. You can see now I'm getting 9, now I'm getting 8. Okay, we'll just create that one. We'll see how to do that. Now inside my display.php, here I have my anchor tag for my update button. Here inside anchor tag, I'll just give update.php file, and here delete. First I'll be creating delete. So first I'll give this delete.php. Now I'll save this, and I'll create one file named delete.php. I'll just come to my display.php, and here if I refresh this one, now if I click on delete, see I'm redirected to my delete.php file. Now let's perform the operation for delete. Now to get this particular ID, this one, what you can see here. So for that, what I'll be doing is, here I'll just write one question mark, and I'll give this delete ID. Okay, you can give any name here, is equal to the ID what I have defined there. Okay, you can see this ID, whatever ID I'm getting directly from the database, I just want that ID here. Save this file. Now if I come to my project and if I refresh this one, now you can see, now if I toggle ID 1, you can see down you can see here ID 2, ID 3, and also when I click on this above in the URL, you can see this ID, particular ID I got in my URL. Okay, delete ID is equal to 1. Now if I click on 4, see, you can see delete ID is equal to 4. Okay, now using this primary key, that is my ID, I'll be deleting that particular record. So I'll just come to my delete.php file, and here I'll be writing this PHP syntax. First I'll connect to my connect.php file, include connect.php. Now here I'll just check the condition, if is set. Now I'll be using get method, because using get method, we can access the variables, we can access the parameters from the URL. Okay, now I'll check this delete ID. In my URL, as you can see here, if I click on delete button, in my URL I have this delete ID. Okay, this one I'll just write this ID here. I'll just change the spelling. Delete. Now I'll save this, and here I'll write this delete ID, and I'll open braces. Now I'll access that ID. ID is equal to my get method, and inside that one I'll pass this delete ID. Okay, I'm just accessing my delete ID from my URL. This one, I'm just accessing this delete ID from my URL. I'm getting that delete ID, and I'm storing that ID inside my ID variable. Okay, now I'll just write one query here, delete query SQL. I'll give my query delete from table name. My table name is CRUD. Okay, I'll just give the condition where my table ID is equal to this whatever ID I have defined here, this one. Okay, this ID, this is my table ID. My table ID is equal to this ID. Okay, now I'll execute this query. To execute this query, I'll just create one variable, and I'll give MySQLi query. Inside this, I'll be passing two parameters. First is my connection variable, and second is my query variable. Now I'll just check the condition. If my result is true, then show me echo deleted successfully. I'll just give this, and here else I'll just come to my connect.php. I'll copy this one and I'll be pasting it here. Now I'll save this. I'll just come back, and if I refresh this one, now if I click on delete, you can see I did not get anything. Let's see, if I refresh this one, it's not getting deleted. Inside my, okay, I'll just change the spelling. I'll just give this delete. Now if I come and if I refresh here, now if I click on delete, I'm getting deleted successfully. I'll just come here, I'll refresh this. You can see my one, the ID number one has got deleted. Now if I click on two, and if I come back, if I refresh this, you can see my ID three, my ID two has been deleted. Okay, once the particular record is deleted, I don't want to go to my delete page. Okay, I should be redirected to my display.php. Okay, so for that, I'll just come to my delete.php file. Instead of this one, I'll just give this header, and I'll pass the location here. My location, I'll give it as location. I'll give my display.php file, display.php. Now I'll save this. I'll just come here, and if I refresh this one, if I click on delete, see it's getting deleted, and it is redirected to my display.php file. It is not moving to my delete.php file. Okay, now we are done with the delete operation. Now let's perform our update operation. For update as well, so we should know which ID we are updating. So for that also we need ID number. Whenever we toggle this one, we need particular ID should be displayed, like how it is getting displayed in delete. Below you can see delete ID is equal to 4. So in the same way in update also I need the same thing. So for that also I'll just do the same thing how I did for delete. I'll just come to my update button, and here after update.php I'll just give one variable. Update ID is equal to this particular ID, whatever I have assigned, this one, whatever values I got from the table, I have assigned here. Now I'll save this, and here I'll be creating my update.php file. I'll just come, I'll refresh this one. Now if I toggle on update, you can see update ID is equal to 4. If I click on this, you can see this particular update ID is equal to 4, and I am inside my update.php file. Okay, this is the URL I got. Now let's create the code for our update.php file. Now when I click on update, I want all the form, whatever. Now if I show you on my previous project, if I click on update, you can see I'm getting this form and I'm getting this update button. So to get the form, I have my form in my users table. You can see I have this particular form in my users table. I'll just copy this entire code of my users table, and I'll be pasting it here. Okay, now instead of submit, I'll just change it to update. Once I change the text of my button, I'll just come to my PHP, whatever code is here. See here, my data is connected. Now here I'll be checking the condition. If my post method is equal to submit, then I'm accessing all the variables. Okay, you can see here I'm writing the same code. I have copied the same code from my user.php file. Okay, this entire thing, and I have displayed here. Okay, I have pasted here. I am checking the condition. If my post method, that is if it is equal to submit, then I don't want to insert the data. I want to update my data. Okay, so I'll be writing here my update query. I'll just give this update table name. My table name is CRUD, so I'll be writing my table name, and I want to set the ID. Okay, first I'll just access my ID here. I'll just create one ID variable, and I'll just access my parameter from here using get method, and my field I have given as update ID. Okay, whatever I have given here inside my display.php file, this particular name update ID, I have just written here update ID, and I'm getting that using get method, and I'm storing that ID inside my ID variable. Okay, this ID variable. Now I'll just write this update method, update CRUD set. Okay, my ID variable, my table ID is equal to that particular ID what I have assigned just now. My table name is equal to this particular name I want to set to this name. Then I have my email is equal to that particular variable, email variable. And next I have my mobile. I'll just give this mobile, and I'll be assigning it to mobile variable. And next I have my password, and I'll be assigning that to my password variable. Now if you see here, my ID is integer, my name, this all fields are my varchar. So I should enclose this everything in single quotes. I'll close everything in single quotes. Now here I have executed my query using MySQLi query, and inside that I'm checking this condition. Now I'll just remove this header, and I'll just give here updated successfully. And I'll uncomment this one. I'll save this. Now let's just see the output. I'll just come here. I'll refresh this one. Now if I click on update, okay, I got error unexpected if on line 4. Here I'll just put semicolon here. Now if I refresh this one, okay, undefined index update ID on line 3. This spelling update ID, I'll just save this one now. Now if I refresh this, updat, okay, this particular field I'll just give here. I'll just give update ID. Now I'll save this. Now if I refresh this one, okay, now my errors have gone. I'm inside my ID 4. I'll give one name here. I'll give pihu. I'll give email as pihu@gmail.com. Mobile, I'll give some number. Password, I'll give 123. Now I'll update this one. Now if you see here, I'm getting this duplicate entry 4 for key primary. Okay, it's telling me that inside my database with key 4 I have already displayed one data. Now I can't insert the data, but we are updating our data. So what we have to do is, inside our update query, you can see inside my update query, I have set this ID is equal to the ID what I got from my parameter, okay, what I got from my URL. I am just setting that ID to this one, okay, my table ID, and my name, whatever I'm getting after updating, that I'm setting revalues I'm assigning here. Now here I should give one condition. Okay, my condition is where my ID is equal to the ID what I'm getting from my parameter, only that particular value you set, okay, or else you don't insert the value, you just have to update the value. Okay, now we told our query to perform this condition. Now let's just check this. Now I'll just come to my display.php file. I'll refresh this one. Now if I click on update, now my name was Priya there. Okay, I'll just give Pihu. I'll give the email as pihu@gmail.com. Mobile number also I'll update. I'll give 111. Password I'll give 1234. Now if I click on update, okay, you can see updated successfully. I'll just change here, updated successfully. Now I'll save this. Now if I come to my display.php file, now you can see on my ID 4 I have priya@gmail.com and some mobile and password. Now as soon as I refresh this, see my data got updated. Now in this we have one particular problem. Now if I click on Suresh to update this one, I want all that fields should be filled here, okay, in my program, in my previous program. See, if I click on this particular update field, see, before only all my particular fields are getting displayed, okay, so that I don't get confused what should I update. Okay, you can see here if I click on Rita, all the particular fields related to Rita are getting displayed here. Now if I click on my project, you can see my data is not getting displayed. Okay, now we'll see how to display the data here. Whenever I click on this update, all the fields related to Pihu should be displayed in my particular fields, so that I just have to update whatever I want and I'll click on update and that should be updated. Okay, so for that what we'll be doing is, okay, here below my ID where I am extracting my ID, I'll just write one query here. I'll just write one SQL query and I'll give this select star from my table name. I want to display all the data, so select star from my table name, okay, where my ID is equal to the ID what I am getting from my URL. Okay, I'm just giving this condition. Now I'll execute this query. To execute this one, I'll just create one variable and I'll be writing this MySQLi query. Inside this I'll be passing my connection variable and second parameter is my query variable. Okay, now here in my display.php file, you can see here, okay, in my display.php file, to display the data I have used this method MySQLi fetch async inside my while loop. Okay, before that I showed you to display single data only once we have to write this and we have to assign that this function, this method in one variable. Okay, let's just see how to do that one. I'll just create my row variable. Inside this I'll be writing this MySQLi fetch async method and inside this one I'll be passing my result variable. Okay, I want only this particular ID data should be displayed, so I want only once, not in the while loop. I want only once, so I'll be assigning this value to only one variable, okay, not inside my while loop. Now using this method I can access the data from my database, okay, as we have seen inside the display.php. Now if you see here, inside my while condition I have created some variables and I have accessed the data and I have assigned the data to that particular variable. Okay, now in the same way I'll be doing for my update here also. I want my name. I'll just access it using this one row. I'll be giving this name. This name is my table column field. Okay, this is my variable. Now I want email. Email is equal to row and I'll be giving this email column name. Next I have my mobile. I'll give this mobile. I'll access mobile row. And I'll be passing mobile. Okay, it's mobile. Now next is my password. I'll create a variable for password and I'll access that one row and I'll give this password column field. Now I'll save this. Now if I come and if I refresh this, and I'll not be having any change. Okay, now if I refresh my display.php, if I click on update, I don't have any change because till now I have not assigned any value. Now if I just come here and I'll just show you an example of value, I'll copy this entire div and I'll be pasting it here. Instead of name here, I'll just give one value and I'll give 1234. Now if I save this and if I come here and if I refresh this one, you can see I have this password field and the value whatever I have given that one, it is got displayed here. You can see here clearly whatever value I have assigned here, it is got displayed into that particular field. Okay, this is how we'll be displaying our value. Now I'll just remove this one. Now inside all my input fields, I'll give here value attribute and inside that I want to assign this value. Okay, this particular value, this from whatever I got from my table, okay, this particular value, name, email, mobile and password, not this one, this one, name, email, mobile, password. Okay, so inside my value, I'll just write this PHP, and I want to echo my, first I want to echo my name. I'll just give this name and I'll be closing my PHP. Now I'll save this. I'll come to my display.php. I'll refresh this. Now if I click on name, you can see the name has displayed here. Okay, now if I click on Suresh, see the Suresh name has displayed here. In the same way, I'll be passing for email, mobile and password. Okay, so I'll just come here for my email. I'll just give this value. Inside this value, I'll be creating my PHP. And here I'll just echo my email field. Okay, email variable, I'll close my PHP. Here also I'll be creating value. I'll create my PHP syntax. I want to echo my, I have mobile here. In the same way for password also, I'll just create value PHP echo password. Now once we are done with this, I'll just come here and if I refresh this one, now if I click on update, you can see all the values have got filled and whatever data is inside this particular folder, this particular ID, that everything got displayed here. You can see here phoo@gmail.com, the mobile number and the password. Now if I want to change phoo to, I'll just give instead of phoo, I'll just give Ria here. Ria, email also I'll change it to Ria. Now if I click on update, see updated successfully, and if I come here and if I refresh this one, you can see my phoo is been updated. Now I don't want that update should get displayed. Instead of that, I just want to redirect it to my user.php file, display.php file. So instead of this, I'll just uncomment this one. Now I'll refresh this. Now if I click on Suresh, instead of Suresh, I'll give Ramesh. Email, I'll give it as Ramesh. Mobile also I'll change. I'll give 111111. Password, I'll give 222. Now if I click on update, you can see my field has updated. Instead of Suresh, I got Ramesh. Everything, all the fields have been updated. Now if I click on add, I can add new users here. I'll add my name Khanam. Khanam@gmail.com. Mobile number, I'll give random number. And password, I'll give some number. If I click on submit, you can see the data has been inserted. Now if I click on delete, my data is getting deleted. Now if I click on update, all the fields have been displayed and I can update the value here. If I click 12, if I click on update, you can see Khanam 12 has been updated. Okay, that's all for today's project. Thank you so much for watching this.